In this video, I'd like to talk to you about some actions that result oftentimes in a loss of trust in a negotiation. So what can you do in a negotiation that will result in the other party losing trust in you? All right, to start with, any breach or defection from doing what the other party believes that you will or should do. Okay, trust at its very nature is the other party's belief that you will act in accordance with how they believe you act or that you should act, right? A breach or defection is when you do something completely different, right? So once again, it can cause the other party to lose trust. They will not trust you again, or at least it'll diminish their trust in how you're going to act because they've shown already that you will not act in accordance with that, okay? Next is miscommunication. All right, not communicating yourself so that the other party understands you or the situation well, right, can cause them to trust that you act a certain way. And then when you don't act that way, not intentionally, right, but they don't understand why you act a given way. If they don't believe that they understand or have a good reasoning for how you acted, why, that type of scenario, then once again, they are less likely to trust in you or trust that you act in a certain way in the future. Okay, so communicating clearly is very important. And lastly, dispositional attributes. And that's our tendency to associate good or bad things with somebody based upon their personality or personal characteristics. Okay, that is, if I believe you're a bad person, I don't trust you, right, because I think you're a bad person. When actually those things are completely separate. Whether someone is going to act how you expect them to act and whether they're a good person or not are completely separate. But when we imply or assert that you will act in a certain way based upon this disposition that is completely unrelated, right, that is a dispositional attribute that will cause a loss of trust in the negotiation. So one example of this is the halo effect. We tend to believe that others, and I apologize, halo is misspelled on my slide I see in front of me, but the halo effect basically is our tendency to associate all good things with someone based upon their performance or who they are as a person. And then the forked tail effect is the opposite. We tend to see everything that someone does is bad or awful because we hold them out as being a bad, or we see them as being a bad or negative person. Okay, so in any event, any of these actions, right, our tendencies towards any of these breaches, defections, miscommunication, or our dispositional attributions can cause a loss of trust in a negotiation.